biggest bash is yet to be. Oh, when it all starts happening, I wanna be there. Don't wanna miss that long white robe affair. When the shouting has begun, I'll show heaven how it's done. When it all starts happening, I wanna be there.
All that welcome day of our revival, there won't be one hand that doesn't wave. The band all finished tuning, not one singer crooning, millions shouting, singing, we are saved.
Well, no one wants to leave before it's over, always keeping one eye on the door. Heaven's only known a fraction, soon will come the main attraction. This is what we've all been waiting for.
Oh, when it all starts happening, I wanna be there. Don't wanna miss that long white robe affair. When the shouting has begun, I'll show heaven how it's done. When it all starts happening, I wanna be there.
Oh, when it
all starts happening, I wanna be there. Don't wanna miss that long white robe affair. When the shouting has begun, I'll show heaven.
Gospel music from Mercy's Mark. That's called When It All Starts Happening, I Want to Be There. And welcome to Gospel Time. I'm the host, Dave Rigg, and during this half hour, it's going to be my privilege to bring to you the gospel of Jesus Christ in song. Here's one from Mike Upright, "The Only Fire I'll Ever Feel." You're listening to Gospel Time.
Place somewhere below I've heard and read about. They say that people when they go can never come back now. A place of torment for lost souls who turn the Lord away. They say the fire burns all night because there is no day. But I escaped that awful place when Jesus saved my soul. And not one hair upon my head will into that place go. No, I don't have to worry since the Savior took my part. The only fire I'll ever feel is burning my heart. Eternal life was given me when I was born again, and His precious blood has covered me and cleansed me from all sin. He left a spark that satisfies my hungry soul's desire. And that tiny flame that's burning now will keep me from the fire. Cause I escaped that awful place when Jesus saved my soul. And not one hair upon my head will into that place go. I don't have to worry since the Savior took my part. The only fire I'll ever feel is burning in my heart. The only fire
in my heart.
In the 138th Psalm, verse 8, God's Word says, "The Lord will fulfill His purpose for me. Your love, O Lord, endures forever. Do not abandon the works of your hands." Would you pause just a moment with me for a word of prayer? O Sovereign God, our prayer today is that you would help us to see today what our lives are intended to fulfill in your plan. Thank you, Lord, for loving us and promising to walk beside us every step of our lives. Lord, we live trusting that you will never forsake us and committed to never forsaking you. In the name of your faithful Son, Jesus, we pray, and amen.
There are over 300 prophecies in the Bible fulfilled by Jesus. Amazing Alan will now illustrate the odds of those prophecies coming true.
How am I going to do that when I'm strapped to the propeller of an airplane with a milkshake in my hand?
The probability of Jesus fulfilling all those prophecies is about the same as Alan being able to drink that milkshake without spilling a drop.
Okay, you're talking about specific prophecies, right? Like being betrayed for 30 pieces of silver or being born in Bethlehem.
That's right, Alan.
Well, I don't get it. All those prophecies are nearly impossible to fulfill. Drinking this milkshake is a piece of cake.
Right. Let's go.
Okay.
Contact.
Contact.
Oh, looks like Alan dropped his milkshake.
There's no place like home.
Jesus said that no one can go to God except through him. No person in history has the qualifications to make that claim except Jesus.
A message from Lifeline Productions.
Our next song is from the Freemans, and this is called "I Need a Drink." Listen to the words.
A 17-year-old boy on the east side of town gets caught up in a bad drug deal when it goes down, and another 10-year-old baby girl's missing tonight. Why her heartbroken mom and dad plead for that little girl's life. When I get depressed from all the bad news on TV, I need a drink. Lord, I need a drink from the river of life. My soul has a thirst and my hope is run dry. I need an escape, only you can provide. While this world slowly sinks, I need a drink. I've tried to quit reaching for crutches and do this alone. Be strong and handle the stress of this world on my own. But Lord, you're a habit I just can't seem to give up. I'm addicted to your love and how you fill my empty cup. I catch myself reaching for you, Lord, when I am weak. I need a drink. Lord, run dry. I need an escape, only you can provide. While this world slowly sinks, Lord, I need a drink from the river of life. My soul has a thirst and my hope is run dry. I need an escape, only you can provide. While this world slowly sinks, I need a drink.
They went right into the house where he was staying, and Jesus asked them, "Do you believe I can make you see?" "Yes, Lord," they told him, "we do." Then he touched their eyes and said, "Because of your faith it will happen." And suddenly they could see. Jesus sternly warned them, "Don't tell anyone about this." But instead they spread his fame all over the region. When they left, some people brought to him a man who couldn't speak because he was possessed by a demon. So Jesus cast out the demon, and instantly the man could talk. The crowds marveled. "Nothing like this has ever happened in Israel," they exclaimed. But the Pharisees said, "He can cast out demons because he is empowered by the prince of demons." Jesus traveled through all the cities and villages of that area, teaching in the synagogues and announcing the good news about the kingdom. Matthew 9:28 through 35 from the Holy Bible, New Living Translation. For those who thirst.
This is Gospel Time, a radio ministry. We depend upon your prayers and financial support to keep us on the air in your area and on your favorite radio station. If you'd like to help us, write to us at Gospel Time, Box 68, Bone Gap, Illinois, 62815. Write us today.
Now on Gospel Time, it's Hymn Time.
Sweetest name. tells of a one whose loving heart can feel my deepest woe, who in each sorrow bears a part that none can bear below.
Just about anything these days. I like to save coupons.
Oh, that's a good idea. I love to save money.
Oh, who doesn't? You can save gas.
Yep, you can save time.
Save your breath.
Save the best for last.
No, good. Save me a seat.
How about save room for dessert?
Oh, that's a great save.
Yes. Save a tree.
Save a whale.
You can save energy.
You can save water.
Electricity.
Save your marriage.
That's right. You can even save a life.
Ooh, but there's one thing you can't save.
You can't save your own soul. Mm-hmm. Only Jesus can do that.
Yep, we have to trust in Jesus.
Trust in his death and his resurrection.
That's the only thing that will save you.
Acts chapter 4 says there's no other way to be saved.
We all deserve punishment.
There's only one way to save yourself.
Let Jesus do it.
He's the real lifesaver.
Save time today to read Acts chapter 4.
A thought worth saving from the pages of our daily bread.
Okay, thank you. Here's a song now from the Northmen. This is called Going Up to Heaven Someday.
When I leave this world, I'm gonna fly away to my home's eternal land and unclouded day. Joys are nothing can compare. Wait for me there. I'm going up to heaven someday. And my Savior for a, won't that be a wonderful time? In our home in heaven sublime, there'll be no sorrow, no tears evermore, when I shall move to that heavenly shore. You'll be going with me, I pray. I'm going up to heaven someday.
When my life is over and my race is run, when I hear my Savior say, my child, well done, I will be so happy just singing his praise. I'm going up to heaven someday. Well, I know I am going to heaven someday to live with the saints and my Savior for a.
Something about all our stuff or put a match to it.
Or the other commandment, you shall be organized. This is Elizabeth George for A Woman After God's Own Heart. That wonderful and sometimes irritatingly convicting Proverbs 31 woman began her schedule early before her family was up. Careful scheduling takes care of housework, bill paying, errand running, meal planning, juggling job and children and husband. It gives you time to spend with God, doing what God wants you to do. With what I call the one-foot method, I clean out at least one drawer, one shelf, or 1 foot of space every day. And usually, while I'm doing something else, like warming something in the micro, waiting for coffee to brew, talking on the phone, whatever method you use, have one. And blessings to you. This is Elizabeth George.
Have I not yet been told? I can hardly wait. Well, we've read about and we've heard about this man from Galilee. How he left this world to prepare a place for you and me. His glory we will share in that land so bright and fair. It won't be long until we'll be going there. His face I finally see. I'll hear him call my name. Forever with him I'll reign. But I know I'll never be the same. Oh, I am gonna see Jesus some sweet day. I know that with him I will stay. I'll walk down the streets of gold. I'll see the half but not yet been told. I can hardly wait. Oh, I'm gonna see Jesus some sweet day. I know that with him I will stay. I'll walk down the streets of gold. I'll see the half but not yet been told. I can hardly wait.
Yes, I'm going to see Jesus someday. That was music by Biney English.
Back to Genesis with Dr. John Morris, creation researcher and scientist with ICR. Dr. Morris, I've heard of something called colony collapse disorder. Can you explain this?
Well, Chris, for probably over a century, honeybees have been valued for their use in pollinating crops. But today, honeybee populations are declining by up to 80%. It appears that the bees are dying before they're able to return to the hives, while bees left in the hives are sickly. The colonies are collapsing. This is a serious problem, as we're dependent upon the honeybee for much of our food. Experts have no idea what's causing it. Is it the genetically modified foods, or mites, or viruses, or stress? Maybe it's the noise, or pesticides. No one really knows. This should point us back to the Creator's provision and care. We also need to humbly acknowledge our finite understanding compared to His wisdom. He created it all, back in Genesis.
This is Chris O'Brien. Thanks for going back to Genesis.
This song is from his song. It's called First Things First.
It was not as I imagined. In this dream I had of heaven. As I walked into the city, there was so much going on. And before I even knew it, but my feet, they started running. And I found myself excited as I ran toward the throne.
Well, I ran past several loved ones who had helped me on my journey. They had told me about Jesus and what grace was all about.
Oh, my heart just jumped to see them, but my feet, they started running. Oh, they wanted me to visit, but I smiled and said, not now. I could hear the harp
of David playing somewhere in the distance. And I almost stopped to listen, but my feet just wouldn't stay. There were mansions of such beauty that they took my breath right from me. But I had to come back later, but my heart just wouldn't wait. And I said, first things first, I've got to find my way to Jesus. First things first, I've got to kneel before the throne. And in a brand new language, I'll sing praises unrehearsed and thank Him for the sacrifice that took away sin's curse. It's gonna take eternity to tell of what He's done for me. I want to see it all, but first things first. Jesus, first things first, I've got to kneel before the throne. And in a brand new language, I'll sing praises unrehearsed and thank Him for the sacrifice that took away sin's curse. It's gonna take eternity to tell of what He's done for me. I want to see it all, but first things first. I want to see it all, but first.
That's all the time they're going to give us for Gospel Time today. Here is our mailing address. It's Gospel Time, Post Office Box 68, Bone Gap, Illinois, 62815. Write to us today. Well, thanks for listening to our program today. Until our next radio broadcast, if the Lord's willing, this is Dave Rigg asking the Lord to richly bless you.